Daniel Hand, we're back for episode 5.
Yeah, it's hard to believe that we're already 5 episodes in. Time flies.
You know what else has been going really fast? Spring sports.
I know. I spent the whole offseason working on my swing, and now season's almost over.
What, for baseball?
No, for golf. I've been feeling like prime John Daly out there.
You know, I've always wanted to get into golf, but, you know, the hips are a little too tight for that.
To be honest, I don't even know if I'd make the team.
Yeah, maybe golf isn't for us. Anyways, let's go check up on our golf team.
Sports have always been a cornerstone of the Hand community. While many think of football, basketball, lacrosse, baseball, and even gymnastics, the golf team has been competing at a high level for the past several seasons, but still doesn't drive the fans to come watch.
So the Hand girls golf team does not pull out any spectators, although yesterday I think we had 2.
Hello darkness, my old friend.
Spectators are permitted, though. Feel free to come. You can walk the holes with us. It's a good time, but yeah, no, we don't tend to pull out a lot of spectators.
What would you say to the people who think golf is a boring sport?
It's not boring to play. It's definitely not an upbeat sport. You know, it's nothing. It's not like football or soccer, baseball, those types of things. It's a fun sport, though. I personally don't love watching it unless it's the PGA, but it's a fun sport to play.
Have you ever been to a Daniel Hand High School golf meet?
I have not.
Absolutely not.
No, I have not.
It was either freshman or sophomore year where I tried out, and I didn't make the team, and I was like the only one who didn't make the team. To answer your question, no, I have not been to a golf tournament or for Hand.
With the Daniel Hand golf team in the midst of a great season so far, their winning record will continue as the boys team takes on Amity at home and the girls team plays East Lyme. Both matches will take place on Monday. Show your support by coming to a match and cheering on your fellow Tigers.
Matt Gagliardi preparing to hit with a gap wedge here. Normally you'd see a pitching wedge from him in this situation, but it seems that the wind is back. He doesn't want to risk it. He swings back. Some good lift under that one. And it's on the green. That could set him up for par.
What's one thing you wish to say to all golf fans?
Tee it high and let it fly. Chick stick the long ball.
Best of luck to the Daniel Hand golf team. Here with the rest of the fan base, and as both of Daniel Hand's spectators, this is Brian Girardi reporting.
Man, all that golf must have tired them out and made them hungry. I wonder where they're going to go after this.
I for sure would go to Deli U.
I got to agree with you, Mr. Kranz, but I heard a lot of people saying they would rather go to Bradley and Wall.
You know, I get it. Good thing Ella, Liv, Jade, and Julia are taken to the halls of Daniel Hand to settle the debate.
Guilford and Madison have had a rivalry since the beginning of time. Deli U, an arguably loved hidden gem located in Guilford, is known for its sandwiches, subs, and wraps. Bradley and Wall, a hometown go-to stop here in Madison. It's known for every entree there is under the sun.
B-Wall or Deli U?
B-Wall.
What's Deli U?
Bruh.
B-Wall.
Gotta be B-Wall.
Deli U. No labors. Consistently.
If you want a good chicken cutlet sandwich, the best chicken cutlet sandwich in the world, you go to Bradley and Wall. That's where you go to get the best sandwich in the world.
Deli U all the way.
If you walk in to Bradley and Wall, you will feel spiritual energy. Bradley and Wall has it, so I walk in, I'm like,
Deli U has some.
I'm entranced by it. I can feel the energy radiating off, and I sense something deep inside my soul.
And then Deli, I walk in, I'm like, ugh.
Here in Madison, we take our shoreline subs very seriously. So today we took the beef out of the kitchen and into the halls of Danny Hand. We had 2 Bradley and Wall fans secretly try a Deli U sandwich.
Pretty gas, not bad. But the bacon definitely puts a good touch. Whatever this sauce is, I think it might be mayo. Love it.
Did you like the Deli U sandwich?
What Deli? This is a Deli U sandwich? Wow.
Got it!
What I've never known. It's very good, actually. I like it a lot.
Would you cheat on B-Wall with this sandwich?
Yeah, I wouldn't call myself much of a cheater. I would never cheat. But for Deli U, I definitely would cheat on B-Wall.
Well, I guess it's still debatable. What do you think? From outside the cooking class where our sandwich chefs are born, this is Jade Brewer reporting.
Yeah. Look. Can you get gas at B-Wall?
A gas station. I don't want to go to a gas station for a sandwich. I want to go to a gas station for gas.
Oh, that's the charm, folks. Like, I'm trying to eat a Randy Johnson.
I want to eat a Larry Bird.
I've seen more flavors of Cape Cod chips at Del U than I've seen in Cape Cod. It's
even though Del U is in West Madison, it'll still have a place in my heart.
Well, that's all for this week's Tiger Talk. We will see you guys next week.